Hi, once again welcome back to Obstetrics and Gynecology videos. Today we are going to see about the levels of neonatal care. On the basis of the therapies and services provided in each levels, the American Academy of Pediatrics categorizes the hospitals into four levels. These four categories are level 1, 2, 3 and 4. The level 1 is known as well newborn nursery, and the level 2 is special care nursery, level 3 is neonatal intensive care units or NICUs, and level 4 is regional neonatal intensive care units or regional NICUs. In the level 1, that is in well newborn nursery, it's typically referred to as well newborn nursery. The facilities this well newborn nursery is having the capability to provide neonatal resuscitation after the delivery and evaluating and providing postnatal care to healthy newborns or infants, stabilizing and providing care of infants born between 35 to 37 gestation and those who are physiologically stable. And this will be having the facility to stabilize the newborn infants who are ill and those who are born less than 37 week of gestation until we are transferring this baby to the appropriate level of neonatal care. So this well newborn nursery means this is the place where we can receive the baby immediately after the delivery, and if the baby is not having any complications and if the gestational age is between 35 to 37 weeks, this setting will be having all the facilities to stabilize and will be having all the facilities to provide care for such babies. And even if the baby is born 35 weeks of gestation or before 37 weeks of gestation also, this facility will be having the capacity to give care for the baby until we are transferring them to a higher level of neonatal care. And this center will be having newborn nurses, or these newborn nurseries will be having pediatricians, family physicians, nurse practitioners, and other advanced practice registered nurses also will be there. Next level is level 2 or special care nursery, that is secondary level. This needs to have all the facilities whatever is there in the level 1 nursery. Along with that, it needs to have the facilities which are available in a pediatric hospital. A neonatologist should be there, a neonatal nurse practitioner should be there, along with the level 2, level 1, these additional things also should be there in the level 2. And this level 2 will be providing care for infants born between 32 weeks of gestation, and those who are, that is, the gestational age should be more than 32 weeks, and the weight of the baby should be above 1000 grams. And those are having physiological immaturity or moderately ill with problems that are expected to resolve rapidly and are not anticipated to need subspecialty services or on urgent basis. That is, if the baby is a preterm baby and if the gestational age is above 32 weeks and if the birth weight is above 1500 grams and if the baby is not having physiological other major problems, only physiological immaturity will be there, and if you are expecting the immediate recovery of the baby, in such cases you can give care at the secondary level. And this provide care for infants who are feeding and growing stronger or recovering from the intensive care. After recovering from the intensive care also, we can keep the baby in this area, and this will be providing mechanical ventilation for short duration, and or it will be providing continuous positive airway pressure also, and stabilize the infants born 32 weeks of gestation and weighing less than 1500 grams. Those babies actually we have to stabilize until we are transferring them to an advanced care setting. So for stabilizing those babies, that is those who born less than even if it is 32 weeks also, if they are not stable and if the weight is less than 1500 grams, immediately we have to stabilize before we are getting time to transfer to the other areas. Till that time, we can give care in the level 2 area. Next one is level 3 or neonatal intensive care unit. And this also need to have all the facilities, whatever is there in the level 2 area and in the level 2, level 1 area, that is pediatricians, family physicians, nurse practitioners and other advanced practice registered nurses, everything should be there. And in addition to that, the level 3 must provide either on-site or at a closely related institution, maybe pre-arranged consultative agreement, the following providers should be there. That is, a pediatric surgeon should be there, a pediatric medical subspecialist should be there, pediatric anesthesiologist should be there, and a pediatric ophthalmologist also should be there. Along with the level 1 and level 2 facilities, we need to have additional surgeons, pediatric medical subspecialist, pediatric anesthesiologist, and pediatric ophthalmologist. And services we are providing and at the level 3 include we can provide sustained life support, provide comprehensive care for infants born at all gestational age and birth weights with critical illness, offer prompt access to full range pediatric medical subspecialist, pediatric surgical specialist, pediatric anesthesiologist and pediatric ophthalmologist. And it provides full range of respiratory support that may include conventional or high frequency ventilation and inhaled nitric oxide. And here we'll be having the facilities for performing advanced imaging and interpretation of such investigations. And this should include CT, MRI and echocardiography also. So these facilities will be there in the level 3 area. The level 4 or regional NICUs, along with the facilities which are available in the level 1, 2 and 3, these regional NICUs will be providing additional pediatric surgical subspecialist also. So in this level 4, we'll be having all the facilities to provide the surgical repair of complex congenital or other acute conditions. So all these surgical corrections will be possible over there because we are having surgical subspecialist. And this will be maintaining full range of pediatric medical subspecialist, pediatric surgical subspecialist and pediatric anesthesiologist at site. And this facilitate transport and provide outreach education also. So these are the 4 levels of neonatal care. Level 1, 2, 3 and 4. Thank you for watching this video, and if you find this video is useful, please subscribe the channel. Thank you.